Welcome to today's lesson. My name is Siamasaka Kriandens. And so today we'll look at organic chemistry, and in particular, we'll look at hydrocarbons. And in particular, we'll look at alkanes. And so we go straight to the lesson. So today we're looking at organic chemistry, and in particular, we're looking at alkanes. Alkanes are actually hydrocarbons, and hydrocarbons are compounds that contain carbon and hydrogen only. So any hydrocarbon will contain only carbon and hydrogen. And so alkanes are saturated because they do not take in more atoms actually to join them, as we'll see earlier in more when we look at organic chemistry in depth. So in naming these hydrocarbons, all of them, they will end with the A-N-E, as you can see from the alkanes, it ends with the A-N-E. So all the alkanes will end with the A-N-E. And so we'll look at the molecular formula, and then we'll look at the structure formula. And so today, basically, we'll look at these three very important aspects, naming of alkanes, actually writing the molecular formula for the alkane, as well as writing the structure formula for the alkane. And so, as I indicated, hydrocarbons, where all carbon atoms are joined together in chains by a single bond, are known as the alkanes. As I indicated earlier, they are saturated because they cannot take in more atoms to themselves during a reaction, because they cannot actually break any bond because they have only one bond. And so the general formula for alkanes is as follows. It will have a carbon and hydrogen indicated. So the N here stands for how many atoms of carbon will that alkane take. And then we have hydrogen should be multiplied by 2N. Okay, plus 2. So this is very important because all the alkanes will be actually, when naming them, they will be generated from the general formula, which is CnH2n plus 2. And so naming and looking at the molecular formula. So the first one we have is methane. Methane, it ends with A-N-E, which is one carbon atom and four hydrogen atoms, meaning that here we're going to have one, and then two times one, which is two, plus two, which gives us four. So that is the methane. Then ethane, it's going to have two carbon atoms. So here where this N, we're going to have two, then two times two, which is four, four plus two, which is six, which is ethane. Propane, we are going to have three carbon atoms. So we are going to have three here. Then on hydrogen, we are going to have two times three, which is six, six plus two, which gives us eight. So this is propane. And notice that all of them here, they are ending in A-N-E. Methane, ethane, propane. Okay, next we have butane, also ending in A-N-E. So there are four carbon atoms. So we have four here, then H, two times four, which is eight, eight plus two, which gives us 10. So that general formula goes on. And then for, again, I'll skip this one. This, we are doing the same thing. I'll go to hexane with the six carbon atoms. So we're going to have six here, Then for hydrogen, we'll have to have 2 times 6, which is actually 12, 12 plus 2, 14. And then it means that we have hexane. So 5 carbon atoms for an alkane is known as pentane. 4 carbon atoms in alkanes is known as butane. And 6 carbon atoms in alkanes is known as hexane. So we have known how to name and give the molecular formula for an alkane. So we have done two things here, naming, giving it a name, as well as how to write the molecular formula. So these are molecular formulas. Now we go into how to write structure formulas for alkanes. We'll start with the one with one carbon atom, which is methane. So it has one carbon atom, as we saw earlier, and 4 hydrogen atoms. So we'll write the carbon atom in the middle, and we'll write the strokes around, because around carbon, there should be 8 electrons in the outermost shell. So this actually one bond here is for 2 electrons. So there are 2 electrons here, 2 here, 2 here, 2 here, which makes them 8. And 2 electrons around the hydrogen. So this is how we write the structure formula for methane. Next, we write the structure formula for ethane with the 2 carbon atoms. So write first of all the carbon atoms, right? You join first the carbon atoms, and then around them there should be 4 bonds. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 around the carbon atom. Even here there should be 4 bonds, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then here we can put hydrogen, put hydrogen, put hydrogen, put hydrogen, put hydrogen, put hydrogen. So there will be 6. So this is the structure formula for ethane. If we want to write the structure formula for propane with 3 carbon atoms and 8 hydrogen atoms, first of all, we write the carbon atoms. So we're going to write C joined by another C, joined by another C. And then around each carbon atom, we're going to write 4 bonds. So there's one here, there's one here, there's one here, and the other one we wrote. Okay, similarly here, there will be one here, one here, one here, and another one. One here, one here, one here, and another one there. And then here, write hydrogen, 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 hydrogen. So there will be 8 of them. So this is how we write the structure formula for propane. Structure formula for butane with 4 carbon atoms, we write first of all the carbon atoms, right, joined by a bond, carbon, joined by a bond, carbon, joined by a bond. There are 4 of them. And then around them, we should have 4 carbon, we should have actually 4 bonds. So right, hydrogen here, hydrogen there, 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 hydrogen there. And you'll notice that here in each of them, there are 4 bonds. This is a bond, this is a bond, this is a bond, this is a bond. And each bond here is made out of 2 electrons, because in the outermost shell, for this one to be actually stable, it will require 8 electrons, while hydrogen will require 2 electrons around it. We go to the structure formula for pentane. There are 5 carbon atoms and 12 hydrogen atoms. So you write 1 carbon, 1 carbon, 1 carbon, 1 carbon, 1 carbon. Each one of them should be joined by a bond. And around them, we write hydrogen there, 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 and hydrogen there. All of them, there'll be 12. Ensure that around each carbon atoms, there are only four bonds. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. To this one, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the structural formula for hexane. So I thought this would help us actually to know how to write the general formula and be able to write the molecular formula and be able to write the structure formula, as well as the naming of alkanes. And so next time under the alkanes, we'll look at how they undergo reactions with the other compounds. So I thank you for listening. Please be sure that you subscribe to my YouTube so that you continue getting these lessons. Thank you.